poison on my blade. bit of poison on my blade. Then let's go! A bit of poison on my blade.
Oi, toy!
Bird here to me.
Look at all this. Surely there is something that you would like to trade. Lemsek.
Ato oi. Bird tear to mud. Thank you for coming to talk to me. You are on Olmanawi, but you also look like a Lugaid Blau.
Lugaid Blau?
Is that what you call the congregation?
Yes. Those who have yellow eyes on their banner.
They're coins. But to answer your question, yes. I'm the legate of the congregation.
Is legate the Renaikse word for on Olmanawi?
No. It means that I'm in charge of diplomatic relationships with the other nations.
So I was right. You will be able to help us. Some of your clan are preventing us from accessing one of our sacred glades.
Really? Why would they do that?
Several seasons ago, some men from your clan came to ask us for wood for their houses. There were some old trees in this glade, so we let them do what they wanted. At first, everything was fine. But then they cut down too many trees. So we wanted to heal the place, plant some new trees. But they won't let us come close. Their bod irony, their warriors, are stopping us from doing so.
I could investigate.
Yes, please. You must tell them that they have to let us heal the glade.
Bertir Tumad. I am Dunkas, the Mal and the Donay God of the Yigido. You're very strange for Renaikse. Who are you?
My name is Desarde. I am the legate of the merchant congregation.
You are a Lugeir Blau? Oh, I didn't know there were Onalmanawi amongst them. They may not be so different from us after all. What brings you here, Onalmanawi?
What do you think of the settlers from the continent?
I think they behave like naughty, unruly children. They take what they want and break what they own without even understanding what they are doing. But they can learn and grow. And who would kill unruly children for being mischievous?
Is there anything else?
I must leave. Goodbye, Dunkas.
Qua awalum seg.
poison on my blade. Then let's go! Let's see if you can roll off this crate.
Thank you. bit of poison on my blade, and let's go! Bit of poison on my blade. And let's go! Let's see if you can ward off this space!
These are some unusual customers.
Greetings, my lord.
It's a real pleasure to have a customer such as yourself. How may I help you? Thank you. It was a pleasure.
Desarde, I'd like to know more about my family. I need to know what became of them. Could you accompany me to see Lady Morange? I'm afraid that without you, she may refuse to give me any information.
All right, Vasco. Let's go see Lady Laureen Morange.
Cousin! You have returned to me. Your absence was sorely felt.
We don't appear to be in top form. A house intrigue's keeping you from finding proper sleep.
No, nothing to bring me nightmares as of yet. I'm blaming it on the change of diet. Now, tell me what adventures you've been up to. If you only knew how bored I grow behind these walls.
We were not able, alas, to stop the clash between the forces of the Alliance and Siora's clan. We arrived at the village and the battlefield too late. The Queen fell.
I'm extremely sorry for your loss, Princess.
Thank you. My sister survived, fortunately, and we are recovering from this tragedy together. But our clan was extremely weakened by this battle and by recent events.
We shall keep a close eye on the Bridge Alliance and their undertakings. Rest assured.
You should know that the battle took place in the middle of ancient ruins. The ruins were quite strange. We discovered a fresco that I'm certain was crafted by continental hands.
Really? And how ancient are these ruins? Could they date back to the first landings of the Bridge Alliance?
They date much farther back than their arrival would explain. My mother and my grandmother have always known them.
Siora told me of a legend that spoke of them, about a people from the sea that were vanquished there.
Do you think it was the Nauts?
It is not our custom to found a landlocked settlement. We have our islands and it is enough for us.
If they are ancient, perhaps your people once practiced older customs. This story is troubling, but it reminds me of something that I once read in the reports of Lady Morange. You should go and find her. Perhaps she could tell us more about them.
Very well.
Anything else?
I'm going to leave now. Goodbye, Constantine.
Look out for yourself. It's blocked.
Good day, Lady Morange. Do you remember me?
Sir Desarde, isn't it? I hope that you and your cousin have grown to like it here. But I have little reason to believe you have paid me a visit to exchange civilities. Can I be of service?
What do you know about the ruins found to the northwest of here?
The site that the natives call Didakidnadages.
That is not how we pronounce it, but yes, we are speaking of the same place.
Your language is difficult to master, but I find it fascinating. To answer your question, I had countless questions about the place when our explorers and scouts first brought back sketches. Intrigued, I went there. I noted the architecture and their decorations. It is certain that they bear a striking resemblance with continental constructions, but they are more ancient. too old to have been recently built by the Bridge Alliance settlers when they first set foot on the island. I even questioned the natives, but they only spoke of a people of the sea. My first thoughts went to the Nauts, but they're not known for building large towns, less so cities. There are other ruins on a cliff to the east of here. Perhaps they hide the key to this mystery. I hoped to organize an expedition, but the region is dangerous and hard of access. We explored mines at the bottom of the cliff, but we were not able to find an access to the plateau. If the mystery of these ruins intrigues you as much as me, it is in that direction that you should begin to look for answers. Can I help you with any other matter?
We would like to have some information regarding an important family, the Darcys.
Well, I could tell you many things about them, but I suppose that you want to know something in particular?
Are there any members of this family on the island?
Indeed, Bastian Darcy, the son of the family, has been in New Serene for some time. Last I heard about it, he was doing business, but that doesn't help in knowing where he is. The Darcy's first attempt at establishing themselves on this island wasn't very fruitful, but I seem to recall that since then the son has found a competent associate who's been working here for a long time.
Perfect. Could you tell us where to find her?
Of course. Ask for a Madame Clerc near the warehouses on the port. That's where she normally is. I hope the Darcys are not in trouble.
Don't worry, madam. Their name was simply mentioned in some business discussions. We are thinking about becoming associates. We would like to know more about them to form an opinion.
If you ask me, you should forget this idea, Your Excellency. Their son is a poor business partner.
Why do you say that?
I do not mean to speak ill of him. Perhaps it would be better for you to form your own opinion.
Well, thank you for your help, madam.
Can I help you with any other matter?
My lady, I have to go. Goodbye.
Good people.
Can I help you? Are you here to do business?
Are you Madame Clerc?
We would like to meet with your associate, Mr. Darcy.
Bastian? I don't know where he is. I can't say that he often graces us with his presence.
You don't have the slightest idea where he is.
I am not his caretaker, you know.
You don't seem to hold him in high regard.
Listen, my relationship with my associate is no one else's concern. And if you didn't come to do business, well...
We must find him. This man you can see by my side is his brother.
Do not insult my intelligence. I know that the Darcys only have one son, alas.
You can see the Nort tattoos on his face, can't you? And a merchant like you must surely know about the Nort's recruiting process.
I can see the Nort, but a Darcy? And with all this blue on his face, he doesn't really resemble his brother.
I've got a hunch that your associate has brought you more problems than benefits. What would you say if I offered you some gold to compensate for your losses?
I see that you understand the struggles of a simple merchant. He was supposed to go to Hikmet to deal with one of our clients, but I didn't receive any news from him after his departure. And given his tendency to get himself into impossible situations, I didn't try to get any.
Who is this client?
His name is Ferrat. You'll find him in the Alchemist District. I'll write this down.
You think something may have happened to him there?
His mission wasn't very complicated. He had to pay for a valuable shipment and take charge of it. But with Bastian, anything is possible.
Thank you, madam.
closer. Come closer. Oh.
Hello, sir. Is this the house of the man called Farad?
It is I. What can I do for you?
We're searching for Mr. Darcy. He was supposed to come here to do business.
Yes. Yes, he did come here, but I don't know where he is. To be honest, our exchange did not exactly go as planned. And if you are his associate or a member of his family, know that you owe me a large sum of money.
How so?
Well, this Darcy fellow came here to take the shipment, and he was supposed to deliver me a promissory note.
Which never arrived, I imagine. How could you let him leave with your merchandise without payment?
Well, he's the son of a very well-known family. I did not deem it necessary to try and obtain more guarantees.
What if something happened to him?
Nothing happened. At least I don't think so. And why should that concern me? I'm not his brother. He owes me money, and I do not have the slightest idea of where he might be.
I suspect that you're not telling us everything.
Oh, come on. If you have not come to repay his debt, leave me alone so I can work in peace.
Greetings. If you have come to do business, head upstairs, if there's any business left to do.
Why do you say that?
They haven't been paying me. And I've had to work with cheap ingredients for weeks.
What do you do here exactly?
I create and prepare complex potions. Not simple health potions, but far more subtle things.
And if I'm not mistaken, things are not going the way you would want them to.
The boss has always been difficult, but ever since he got ripped off, it has been a living hell. I work using leftovers thrown away by all the other alchemists. While listening to him screaming at me and everyone else all day, this is no way to live.
Have you heard of a man called Bastian Darcy?
It would be difficult not to. His name is the only thing my boss talks about. Apparently, he did not pay for one of our shipments and still left with the goods. And now my boss makes me work twice as much to compensate for his losses. With ingredients I wouldn't even feed to a pig.
And what did your boss do?
Well, he spent every waking hour cursing his name. That's how I learned about it.
We'll leave you to your work.
How kind of you. I told you everything I know. I must go back to work now.
You again? I already told you that I do not know where the man you're searching for is.
You may not know where he is, but you did everything you could to find him, didn't you?
What do you mean?
Does this document ring a bell? You hired some debt collectors to find Mr. Darcy.
How dare you rummage through my belongings?
You could have taken legal action and retrieved what you were owed, but you sent some killers instead.
I doubt the governor would approve. Do you want us to tell him about it?
No. But please, understand me. The Darcy family is on the continent. It would take months for them to reply to my complaint. What other solution was there? My shop will not survive this.
Tell us who these debt collectors are and we'll take care of it.
They loiter in an alleyway of ill repute, not far from here, in the Science District.
That's what I feared. Probably a bunch of cutthroats. If Bastian survives,
If he survives, remind him of what he owes me.
Everything, I swear. This is nothing but a horrible...
Hey, you! Leave this man alone!
What do you want? No one asked you for your opinion, so get lost!
Maybe he's friends with the Weakling.
Maybe. In any case, it seems like he wants to share his fate.
You think I'm afraid? I've fought uglier people than you.
Vasco, let me try to take care of this. How much money are we talking about? You're here to collect a debt, right?
Between what he owes our client and our commission, it's a hefty sum. But if you want to pay in his stead, my lord, please do.
I'm afraid I don't feel like negotiating any longer.
Glad to see we agree on something.
Poison on my brain! Let's go!
Intervention. I thought these brutes would kill me.
Don't mention it. It's only natural.
But how did you end up in such a situation?
Oh, I'm certain someone like you, who belongs to high society, will understand. There is a game table here that is attended by the best of the aristocracy. I lost the money I owed to that merchant while playing there. And since I got out with a few other debts, I had to leave the merchandise as repayment as well. But that's a mere trifle that my father would have paid for without thinking twice. I never would have thought that someone would send these types of brutes after me. What a lack of tact. In any case, I am extremely grateful to you. To whom do I have the honor of speaking?
My name is Captain Vasco, Nought and Sea Given. It was a pleasure, sir. Desarde, can I do anything for you?
I must leave you.
Thank you, Desarde.
My pleasure. But why didn't you tell him who you were?
But I did tell him. I was stupid. I resented everyone, and you even more, for the life I didn't get to live. You had it all, everything I thought I was entitled to. But after seeing Bastion, I realized that in the end, I was exactly who I wanted to be. A Nought, and a proud one at that.
I'm glad to hear it. No more regrets?
No more regrets. And I certainly don't regret not being called Leandra Darcy.
Blasts, you'll find the quintessence of power.
You'd
better go and meet this governor without me. We are at war. I'm not certain that I can remain calm if I see such a man.
We rarely bow down in our ships. I hope I will not embarrass you.
Your Excellence, it is an honor to meet you. Allow me to present my sincerest regards in the name of the Congregation of Merchants.
And allow me to wish you and your cousin a warm welcome to the island, in the hopes that this visit will help prolong the profitable relations between our two nations.
Likewise. Nevertheless, another question brings me. The Malachor. The Prince d'Orsay hopes that these new shores will bring us new possibilities. Even a remedy.
It is an area that concerns us greatly, but be assured we are studying it acutely. Our doctors and alchemists are particularly interested in the flora of the isle. It's extremely varied and different from our own. In fact, we have sent a group of explorers into a very promising sector. Alas, we've had no news from them for quite some time now. We are hoping that nothing has happened. We would have sent a patrol to investigate, but we cruelly lack the means to do so. The natives have proven aggressive, even hostile to our studies, and have attacked us regularly.
You ask the question why? You steal our lands, gouging the earth in sacred places, and now our people are disappearing. It's enough to drive one to unsheath a blade, do you not agree?
Be still, Siora. It's not the time, nor is it our purpose here.
I warned you. My tongue will not be stilled when such words are cast upon us.
You have made yourself heard. Let it be enough.
I thank you, Excellence. As I was saying, we are obligated to maintain all of our able-bodied men here in order to protect the city. But we would be happy to share with you the results of our research if...
Your Excellency.
This insolent interruption is untimely and unwelcome.
I deeply regret, Excellency, but one of our frontier posts has just suffered a brutal attack.
Report then, and be precise.
The natives attacked us by surprise. Our men were massacred. Our frontier post is lost.
One more act of barbary. Dismissed, soldier. Where was I? Yes, we would be most pleased to share our discoveries with our allies. If your cousin would send us a party to help us find our lost expedition, I could show you to which region they were sent.
I thank you for the information and will let him know.
If you are of a mind to accord me another request, I would be truly grateful.
I'm listening.
As you have not failed to observe, our troops, as well as our caravans, have been suffering incessant attacks. The merchants, including your own, are raided, often killed. And certain goods have become scarce. Captain Reinhild, who commands our outpost in the plains, has communicated his incapacity to protect them. Considering that certain of your own fellow countrymen are involved...
You would like me to lend a hand? I will see what I can do, Your Excellency.
Would you like to speak with me about any other subjects?
I met Ulan, the Boneblower's clan chief, from the village of Vignamri. He is an open-minded man who holds great expectations of exchanges with the colonies. He would like to meet you to discuss a treaty, even an alliance.
Ulan, you say? I have never heard mention of this name, but to finally have an ally among the natives could only be beneficial. That is excellent news. Still, I fear that I cannot leave the city. That would be taking too much of a risk.
I doubt that Ulan will come to Hikmet. He is looking for an alliance, but he is not desperate. Such a gesture would be considered a sign of weakness by his clan.
That is understandable, I suppose. Do they grasp the concept of emissaries? Do you think that solution might work?
I think that might be possible. I'm sure he would understand that you could not come to see him in person for the same reason.
Excellent. Finally, some clear skies in our negotiations with the natives. My right-hand man will then go to this village to finalize an agreement with King Ulan.
I'll be there too, to make sure everything goes according to our plans. There is another matter concerning the same village that I would like to bring to your attention. A wandering merchant, a member of Ulan's clan, is being kept in your outpost. Can you authorize his entry into the city?
I see no harm in that. This merchant is certainly not a threat to us, and he might even prove useful if the negotiations with his clan should take a foul turn. Here, please be so kind as to give him this letter of passage. If he presents it to the guards, they will let him in and he'll be able to establish his stall in town.
I thank you. I hope to see you again. I have to go. Look forward to seeing you again.
Farewell, my lord.